So if you happen to be reading through the liner notes of the 1992 Gin Blossoms debut, New Miserable Experience, you may have noticed that most of the songs on the album, including the two biggest hits from it, were credited to one D. Hopkins, who's also credited with the guitars on the album, but is not listed as one of the members of the band. The same Hopkins would, not long after smashing the Gin Blossoms gold record he received for Hey Jealousy, would shoot himself in the head, a victim of chronic depression, severe alcoholism, and watching the band that he established make it big on the back of his songs, having been fired from the band during the recording of the album. You know how someone just hits you for some reason, straight up, without even knowing why? You just need to find out more about him, check out anything he's ever written or done or sung or recorded. So Doug Hopkins is like that for me. I think he's one of the most gifted songwriters ever, and a guitarist with a really unique sound. He's one of the people responsible for what we now call power pop, these super catchy melodies on a grungy rock backing. And many think that he is one of the biggest misses in the history of music, but unlike lots of other people on that horrible, sad list, like Kurt Cobain, for example, who killed himself not 6 months after Doug Hopkins, it seems like Hopkins is destined to be forgotten. And part of that is because the Gin Blossoms without him kind of faded away and became fairly mediocre. And a lot of that is the fact that he was fired during the recording, before the success. There aren't a lot of interviews, there aren't a lot of photos of him, especially not in that era where, obviously, cameras were not as accessible. Now, I can't guarantee it, but it very well might be that the first song I downloaded off Napster, that legendary music sharing service from the 90s, was Hey Jealousy by the Gin Blossoms, which I had maybe heard twice, 6 or 7 years before, but just always stuck in my mind, and I kept looking for it and eventually found it. This was a huge hit in the 90s and still one of my favorites, and like so many of Doug Hopkins's songs, it deals with his fights with alcoholism and his promises to do better next time. The original lyrics also included an additional reference to drinking, which the lead singer for the Blossoms, Robin Wilson, ended up changing to the word think, saying that there were plenty of references already to alcohol in the band's music, including the name itself, which I guess you can't argue with. You can trust me not to drink and not to sleep around. If you don't expect too much from me, you might not be let down.
Tell me, did you think it'd be alright if I could just crash here tonight? You can see I'm in no shade for driving. Anyway, I got no place to go, and you know it might not be that bad. You were the best I'd ever had. If I hadn't blown the hope 10 years ago, I might not be alone. Tomorrow we can drive around this town and let the cops chase us around. The past is gone, but something might be found to take its place. Hey, jealousy. Hey, jealousy. Hey, jealousy. Hey, jealousy. You can trust me not to drink and not to sleep around. Don't expect too much from me. You might not be let down, 'cause all I really want is to be with you, feeling like I matter too. If I hadn't blown the whole 10 years ago, I might be here with you. Tomorrow we can drive around this town and let the cops chase us around. The past is gone, but something might be found to take its place. Hey, jealousy. my heart. There was only one thing I couldn't stop.
Now, reading of that in Problems with Booze is really depressing. We're not talking about somebody who just likes to get drunk every night. This was a problem throughout his adult life, and at age 31, he had severe liver problems. And by the time the Gin Blossoms end up in the recording studio to record their first album for a major label after many years of hard work, Doug basically can't function. He can't stop shaking when he's not drinking, and he can't stand up and definitely not play his guitar parts when he's drunk. They do manage to record the bass and drums with Doug and the other guitarists of the band, Jesse Valenzuela, playing guitars, guide tracks, which were supposed to be replaced later on in the recording with the actual takes. But later on, Doug himself goes to the producer and asks to be replaced. And unbeknownst to him, at the same time, the band is given an ultimatum to either get rid of him or the label will dump them. He goes back home to Arizona. He actually cleans up a bit, stops drinking, fills up a few notebooks with notes about the recording, but later on finds out that he's actually been fired, and I bet you can imagine what he does later, what he does after that. He also has his hand twisted behind his back. They force him to give up his rights to the songs in return for some money that he's owed. And he's obviously desperate for some cash. Meanwhile, another hit, even bigger than before, also written by Doug, Found Out About You, with some of the creepiest, most painful lyrics you'll ever hear. And as usual, the catchy melody and the contrasting vocals by Robin Wilson, who really always does a fantastic job finding the perfect tone for these songs. You know it's all I think about. I write your name, drive past your house. Your boyfriend's over. I watch your light go out. Doug.
All last summer, in case you don't recall, yours and you were mine. Forget it all. Is there a line that I could write that's sad enough to make you cry? But all the lines you wrote to me were lies. Months roll past, the love that you struck dead. You love me only in my head. There were things you said and did to me. They seemed to come so easily. The love I thought I'd won, you give for free. Whispers at the bus stop. Well, I heard about nights out in the schoolyard. I found out about you. I found out about you. Rumors follow everywhere you go. Like when you left and I was last to know. Well, you're famous now and there's no doubt. In all the places you hang out, they know your name and they know what you're about. Whispers at the bus stop. Well, I heard about nights out the schoolyard. I found out about you. I found out about you. Thank you. streetlights blink on through the car window. I get the time too often on AM radio. Well, you know it's all I think about. I write your name, drive past your house. Your boyfriend's over, I watch your light go out. Whispers at the bus stop. When I heard about nights out in the schoolyard, I found out about you. I found out about you. Whispers at the bus stop. When I heard about nights out in the schoolyard, I found out about you. I found out about you. I found out about you.
Doug kills himself on December 5th, 1993. That's his fifth suicide attempt. He actually had a decent optimistic stretch beforehand. He formed another band. It looked like he would become a sought-after songwriter after having proven the ability to write hit catchy songs. But he ends up getting fired from his new band. The Blossoms are not the same band without him. They did have two additional hits. One of them was a number one from a long-forgotten movie. Robin Wilson ends up breaking up the band, saying he defined himself as the voice of Doug's songs, and that now that he was gone, there was no point moving on. They did reunite later, working kind of hard to be forgotten, unfortunately. And all I do every time I sing or listen to one of his songs is wonder if he thought of the possibility that 30 years later, somebody would still be talking about him. But it's lacking something big this time. What the hell did you expect to find? Aphrodite on a bar stool by your side.
Well, is it any wonder that the stars don't just rush by? When you're only doing 60 on this also vacant night. But it's lacking something big this time. What the hell did you expect to find? Aphrodite on a barstool by your side. 12th night go after something everyone should know. Somewhere in the distance, at a sign, then I saw gin mills, rainfall. What do you remember, if at all? Only pieces of the night. Trampled on, the music gets that loud. Well, you wanted to be where you are, but it looked much better from afar. Hillsides and shadows, two people and the stars. 12th night, we go after something everyone should know. Somewhere in the distance, at a sign, then I saw gin mills, rainfall. What do you remember, if at all? Only pieces of the night. it any wonder where pieces of the night have gone? Twelfth night, we go after something everyone should know. Somewhere in the distance, at a sign, and I saw at all. Only pieces of the night. Twelfth night, we go after something everyone should know. Somewhere in the distance, out of sight, then I saw